Welcome to Darren Daily On Demand, your most trusted resource to help you become better every day. Here's your success mentor, Darren Hardy.
Hey, my Darren Daily friends, why is it that you can't get no satisfaction?
Because I tried, and I tried.
Satisfaction. Why is it? Why do we feel perpetually restless and unsatisfied? And this is even when we live in the safest and the healthiest and the freest and the most prosperous time in the history of our species. Yet we are still unsettled inside. We are still unhappy, unfulfilled, and unsatisfied. And for the striving high achiever, like all of you here with me today, this constant grumbling of dissatisfaction inside is probably magnified 10, maybe even 100 times for some. Would you like to know the reason for this constant gnawing and get a prescription that will take all the pain away? If so, listen closely. The reason for this constant angst of dissatisfaction is it is good for us. At least it has been for hundreds of thousands of years before now. It has been good in driving us to evolve and to adapt and to continue to progress as a species and advance as a civilization. As psychology researchers said, if satisfaction and pleasure were permanent, there might be little incentive to continue seeking further benefits or advantages. We have evolved to be perpetually perturbed so that we'd keep working our tails off, literally, and striving further and farther. So there are four psychological factors that drive our perpetual dissatisfaction. Look out for these as they will drive poor behavior as well. Okay, are you ready? Let me give them to you. Number one is boredom. Man, oh man, the lengths that people will go to in order to avoid boredom is shocking. And I mean, literally shocking. You probably heard about the 2014 study where participants were asked to sit in a room and just think by themselves for 15 minutes. The room was empty except for a device that allowed participants to mildly but painfully electrocute themselves. When asked beforehand, every participant said that they would pay money to avoid being shocked. However, when left alone in the room with the machine and with nothing else to do, 2/3 of men and 1/4 of the women shocked themselves. Many did it multiple times. The study demonstrated that people dislike being alone with their thoughts so much that they prefer to do anything else, even if that activity is negative. Thus, it is no surprise at all that the top 25% of all websites in the United States sell escape from boredom and our daily drudgery. Whether it is through shopping or celebrity gossip or doom scrolling or social voyeurism, even though we know, it is negative and bad for us. Speaking of which, number two, negativity bias. A negativity bias is a phenomenon in which negative events are more salient and demands our attention more powerfully than neutral or positive events. A negativity bias gave us an evolutionary edge. We look for, pay attention to, and remember negative things. Why? Because those are the things that have killed us and our ancestors in the past. This looking out for the negative has been very useful for us surviving as a species in the past. But in the modern world, it is probably directing our demise. Number three, rumination. This is our tendency to keep rethinking about bad experiences by reflecting on what went wrong and how we might have rectified it. By ruminating, people might find errors in behaviors or their approach, which leads them to not repeating mistakes that were made in the past and possibly doing better in the future. So that is another useful process, but it also keeps our angst on a full, constant simmer. And number four is the coolest of them all, hedonic adaptation. This is Mother Nature's bait and switch trick on us. Achievements and accolades we think will make us happier don't, or at least not for long. Hedonic adaptation is our quick return to a base level of satisfaction, no matter what happens to us in our life or what we achieve or what we accumulate. As David Myers wrote, every desirable experience, passionate love, spiritual high, the pleasure of a new possession, the exhilaration of success is transitory. So this is why, no matter your promotions, trophies, awards, paychecks, boats, houses, cars, clothes, shoes, purses, watches, and vacations, even though you try and you try and you try, you can't get no satisfaction. There is no cure for this. All you can do is lessen the grip that this evolutionary fetish has around your neck. And that is to, one, know that this insatiable, never-ending feeling that you have is normal. And know that if you feel it, you are normal. Number two, know that while this evolutionary drive has given us an advantage, it can also now cause and create your mental and emotional disadvantage. You want your perpetual dissatisfaction to drive you, yes, drive you to strive, drive you to grow, drive you to go for better, but not destroy you. Discontent can get you out of bed. It can have you fired up and charging all throughout your day. It can push you past obstacles and setbacks and defeats to finally obtain the financial and lifestyle freedom you desire. But this perpetual discontent will also continue to drive you, having you start more projects, take on more risk and responsibility, increase your liability and obligations, and demand ever more of your time and attention. Now that you know these two very important things about our human species modus operandi, that you are normal when you feel perpetually dissatisfied, and it is good to use that to drive you to grow for better, and you will also have to govern yourself against it so that you don't make dumb decisions that have you screw up your life. So now, with this wisdom on board, now you can get you what you want and live the life that you were meant to live. Hey, Darren here again quickly. I am so thrilled that you are enjoying the production of Darren Daily On Demand. I don't want you to lose sight of how important it is that you stay consistent or get yourself subscribed if you aren't to the every morning discipline of the actual Darren Daily. The transformational magic is in the process, not just the information or the big idea. It is in the ritual and routine to how you kickstart your day. It's calibrating your mind to focus on that one idea and apply it to that very day. Knowledge does not change your life. Behavior does. The action you take on that idea, one idea, each day compounded over time, is what creates the transformational results. Go to DarrenDaily.com if you're not already subscribed, and I will see you there bright and early tomorrow morning.